Wow, it's a lot of people. Hello, some very familiar faces. It's great. And some new faces as well.
Cool.
Welcome, everybody. We are gonna wait for 2 minutes or so, and then we're gonna start with a warm-up. Maybe we can start, who was in the last class? Give me a thumbs up. Wow, that's a lot of people. So I see you're probably already very well warmed up. We heard your Gosha's program was pretty tough on you, I imagine.
We'll start gentle and then ease into something more active.
Exactly, exactly. Okay, looks like the login frenzy has stopped. So we're gonna start with a warm-up song, and then we're gonna explain you a little bit what we have planned for this class, and yeah, then we're just gonna start. Let's do it. Just follow along. And finish on the other side. Oh, music goes wild. All right, I hope you guys are a little bit warmed up now.
Let's introduce ourselves and our plans for today. My name is Julia.
I'm Peter.
Peter is from Austria and I'm from the Netherlands, and we live together in Amsterdam, so that's where we are now. We don't wear masks because we live together.
Yeah. We don't have tulips around, but we are in Amsterdam, I promise. Yeah, our class topic for today is water shag variations. So what we
Variations of water shag variations,
yeah,
I believe.
true. So what we really like to do is taking stuff that we learn and always see somebody has tulips. That's great. Taking stuff that we learn and coming up with some variations on it.
To make it our own. So we don't just take material and then repeat that in our social dancing, but also add something that is us.
Exactly. And we have different ways to do that. We kind of take a variation, see, can we do it in a different pattern? Can we take the same rhythm, put it in a different pattern? Can we add turns? Can we kind of have the rhythm variation a little bit in a different point in the music? So to prep, we have two things for you today. So we're gonna try and split the class up a little bit in the first part and the second part. And for the first part, we are gonna do some drills and then introduce a move where we're gonna use that. And then in the second part, we hope that we are gonna be quick enough with it to show you something else as well that we came up with.
Yes, let's get started with our footwork drill, and it's based around half moons.
Yes, so we're gonna start with half moons, half moons, half moons.
We're gonna start with a half moon for our A version. Half moon, double kick, cross step. So from the front, half moon, double kick, cross step. Peter, can you show that in the version as well?
Yeah. So half moon, double kick, cross step. Half moon, double kick, cross step.
We're gonna do the half moon back and then forward.
Exactly, so that's already our first variation. So you can do half moon back, double kick, cross kick, or half moon forward, double kick, cross step.
Back, double kick,
forward, double kick, cross step. Back, double kick, cross step, forward, double kick, cross step. Double kick, cross step, forward, double kick, cross step.
Cool, that's our option A.
That will be our first option.
We're gonna replace the half moon for option B, and it's gonna be on the second slow. So then we have, I will show from the front first, we're gonna have double kick, half moon,
cross step,
and then we have double kick, forward, cross step. I think I have to go back a little bit. So
Yeah. So instead of the first slow, we're gonna do our half moons now on the second slow. Let's try it out a couple of times. 5, 6, 7, and double kick, half moon, cross step, double kick, half moon, step, double kick, half moon, cross step, double kick, half moon, cross step. All right, there's our second variation. The third one,
we're gonna do half moon, quick, quick.
Yes, so both of the slows will be half moons.
Half moon, half moon, quick. Quick,
half moon, half moon, cross step. Half moon, cross step, half moon, half moon, cross step. Half moon, half moon, cross step, half moon, half moon, cross step. Half moon, half moon, cross step.
Cool. If you like to, you can replace the cross step by an ankle breaker.
Yeah, so if you feel like, okay, I've got the half moon in my pockets, you can make it a little bit fancier by going over and have the ankle breaker in here. Try to not put too much weight on the side of your foot, because it can lead to injury. Try to keep your weight on the foot that's on the floor. I see somebody. Ah, okay. Great. We love half moons as well.
So let's do A, B, and C. We start at A, then we take a little break with B, little break C, little break with these ankle breakers, if you like.
Do you want to go into the bedroom?
Let's just do once, and then we go into the bedroom.
Okay.
5, 6, 7.
First option. Eight. Half moon, double kick, cross. Half moon, double kick, cross. Half moon, double kick, cross. Half moon, double kick, cross.
Alright.
Half moon.
Yeah. So far so good. We'll have option B where we start with a double kick, half moon.
Yes.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Double kick, half moon, quick, double kick, half moon, quick, double kick, half moon, quick, double kick, half moon. All right, let's try the third one out.
And we start with half moon, half moon.
And half moon, quick, half moon, quick, half moon, quick, half moon, half moon, quick.
Good, no questions. We'll put this in a pattern because we would like to do this to swing
chorus.
Chorus.
So exactly.
We're gonna do 5 times A, and then extra quick to make it fill out the music. 5 times B, quick. 5 times C, and then a quick.
Yes. So to fill up our chorus, we will need 2 extra quicks. Let's kind of do this dry ones, I think, so everybody understands what we mean. And then we can do it to music.
Yes.
So we're gonna have 5 basics, a quick extra, 5 basics of the second variation, quick extra, and 5 basics of the double full moons. Let's try that out.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Half moon, quick. Second one, quick. Third one, quick. Fourth one, quick. Fifth one, and double quick. And second variation. Boom. Double kick, slow. Bop. Double kick, full moon. Fourth.
Five.
Five one, double. Quick, full moon, quick. Full moon, quick, full moon, quick, full moon, and double. And then we're gonna wait one chorus and start over again. Is it clear for everybody? Show me a thumbs up, thumbs middle, or thumbs down.
I see mostly thumbs up. So let's just try it. The music will help you too. If you don't like counting, the music will guide you.
Let's do this.
We have Jack I'm Mellow by the Sphinx. All right. But if you turn the sound off, they don't hear us.
Yes. So that's fine.
So it seems like a camera might be mirrored, so we have to check that quickly. This is my right hand. Is it for you?
Magic. This is my
okay,
left
thanks,
hand.
Cool.
All right.
Okay,
yeah. So our camera was mirrored up to now.
Cool.
We switched roles.
Today.
right. Is it clear for everybody? Give us a yay, okay, or I have no clue what we're doing.
So we're good. We can do it to a faster tempo. Cool.
Okay. I will put on a faster song for us. And we're just gonna try the same thing with some faster music.
You know which one?
24. There we go. Hey. Double. Second variation.
Double.
And full moon. Slow.
24 robbers came to my door. Opened the door and let them in. I hit them in the head with the bottle of gin. Just can't understand. 24 robbers fighting one man. One of them took the silverware. It wasn't very good, so I really don't care. I'm gonna warn you. I'll tell you what to do.
What to do.
You better lock your door.
Lock your door.
But the robber men might come back again. I can't sit anymore. Put a big chair right by my front door. Got a shotgun and stood it there to keep the robbers out of my hair. Hit them.
All right. So this is how we like to train our drills. Put it on repeat. I think a lot of people do it like this.
So next step would be doing ABC, ABC, ABC in a row instead of doing 5 times 8.
Yeah.
5 times A, 5 times B. And another thing that I would always like doing is trying to put it in moves. I just do it solo, like in a shag out or in a tuck turn, and just see how I can fit it in by myself before I dance with a leader, and then I try it with a leader later. But we won't do that today, I think, right?
No, since we have ambitious plans for you today, we want to move on to the next thing.
Helmet, pillows.
We're just catching up on the chat right now. okay, so the first thing that we kind of want to variate on today is one of Anders and Egle's really classic moves. I'm sure a couple of you know it already. So it looks like this. Boom, boom, half moon and a Suzy Q. Hey, 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 half moon, Suzy Q. So we really love this move. So we where else in our dance can we use that? And
put it in a shagger push.
Shagger push.
Sam created the name yesterday.
Okay. So
let's show it and then we'll break it down, and we will also talk a little bit about how you could practice it solo.
Yes, exactly. So we're going to show you what we aim for. So from the side to side, we looked into in which figures we can also use the same thing. And we will end up like this. Oh, hey, ooh, ooh, hey, hey. Sugar push. With a half moon and going into Suzy Q. So. All right.
I want to quickly check how comfortable everyone is with Suzy Qs. Can you show me thumbs?
Yeah. How well do you feel with the Suzy Q? Are you good? Yes. Egle, you're good with Suzy Qs. That's good.
All right. Okay. Well, if you're not so comfortable, you can replace this one where we do this nice in and out. We're just cross-stepping.
Yeah. So if you don't feel so well with the Suzy Qs, just cross over and step. Otherwise, rock your Suzy Qs. So the first step to getting there is the regular sugar push. I trust that everybody can do a sugar push. And to kind of get this hip, the hip turn going, leaders, when going in, I'm gonna turn my hip forward towards my left hand and step over and out. And then come back. And for now, just do the quick. So if we want to try it alone, we're going to go forward on the first slow, turn over our standing leg, step crossover, and turn back with a quick.
But we do want to add that nice half moon, so we swing our leg back.
Yeah, so it's going to look slow, half moon, quick. Slow, half moon, quick. Slow. Half moon, quick. Slow, half moon, quick.
Behind hands, slow, half moon, quick.
Yes.
So work those hips.
Slow, half moon, quick. Slow, half moon, quick.
So for those who are partnered, I would suggest to just try this, which you just did solo partnered, and see if that automatically brings your follow with you as well.
Yes. So. If you're a partner, if you have a partner, just connect, maybe do a regular sugar push first. Okay, okay. And then go for the sip turn and see if it works out. Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick.
Solo people can try to focus on the emphasis of the hips forward and then to twist over and correct forward again.
Okay, I can see solo as well as partner people doing awesome. Okay, we're gonna give you a song to try this out.
No, let's add the, if you don't mind, the Suzy Q, and then we play a song.
Oh, okay. We're gonna add the Suzy Q for you guys, and then move on with the song afterwards for you to try it out. So once we're done, or once you feel comfortable with this hip turn, with the half moon, and the quick, quick, afterwards, you can also add just the Suzy Q afterwards. Okay, ho, and the Suzy Q. So, going in, going out, and Suzy Q. I see somebody.
So that would be slow, slow, quick, 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 quick.
Yes. Slow, slow, quick, 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 quick. And then slow, slow, quick, quick. Let's try that all together. And five, six, seven, and slow. Slow, quick, 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 quick.
Basic again.
Exactly.
Do a basic, move and a basic.
Yes. We start off with the basic. And five, six, seven, and slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, 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 quick,
basic.
Slow, slow.
Do you want the spinning version? No. Okay.
All right, how's everybody doing with this? Can we get some thumbs up? Some, yeah, I see some people are still dancing it.
So we'll play some music, and I would suggest for solo dancers to maybe try the thing that I mentioned before, where you combine this with some of your shapes. Check out, for example, and see how that goes.
Yeah, for solo dancers,
oh, wait,
try and throw it in.
Okay. The question someone is asking, how would I feel this as a follow, that it's not another shaker push or sugar push,
yeah,
or that it's going into this inward twist hip
thing. Yeah, so yeah, maybe you can explain what you feel.
Yeah, my leader twists his hip in, so I feel that in the hand connection, because I have my hands, they lie kind of heavy in his hands. The moment he twists in, my body mirrors that, and I feel it in my hands as well.
Yeah.
And so, for the Suzy Q, did you want to add something?
Yes, yeah. Leaders, for a regular sugar push, we will just go straight in, straight out, versus here. Already while going in, I will turn my hip forward and step over in order to communicate this turn, and then kind of pull myself into my partner again.
Yeah, so that hip thing that I mentioned for solo dances is also really important for partners, because that's how you communicate this. And I also wanted to add something on the Suzy Q, because why I feel that it's not just basic is because we travel with this.
Yeah.
And while doing that, Peter makes a wider frame. So it's a very steady frame, and we travel sideways like that together.
Does this answer your question?
I see.
Okay, cool. Then we're gonna play some music for you. Try it out, play it, put it into your social dancing. Which one?
Maybe with the Ice Swing from the Hot Sugar Band. Thank you.
stay there, for thou art so entrancing. My heart goes bing, baby, whenever we start to dance. With all the others, I am a flea McIntyre. But in your arms, I melt away like ice cream on a summer's day. Just one more thing, baby. My life wouldn't be worthwhile till down the middle aisle with the eyes so wink.
All right, everybody. How's it going? Give us a thumbs up. A medium or still no clue what we're doing. Yeah, I see everybody is doing really well.
Let's go.
That song is called With Thee I Swing.
It's by the Hot Sugar Band. We can actually share our Spotify list so you can find all the songs that we use. Share copy link. Yeah, there it is.
We're gonna drop our playlist in the link. In the chat.
Yes.
Okay, as a next step, we also took inspiration from a different combo. Yeah, and we also started side by side. Stop, stop, wait, stop. Hey, stop, stop, hey. Start once more. Stop, quick, slow, quick. So as you can see, we are changing our rhythm here from a six count with a Suzy Q afterwards to a slow, quick, slow. If you want to learn this variation, you should go to Anas and Egle's Patreon, Watershack Patreon, commercial intermission. We are going to use this kind of idea and going to put it into the sugar bush as before. Yeah. So taking this idea of the sugar push, going out, and awesome. Having the quick, we're gonna have the variation with a slow quick. Going in, turning, quick, and using your turn. The whole thing looks like this. Slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick. To break the down, leaders, after going in and having this hip turn going on, you gotta communicate a quick to your follower. So you go in, you give an impulse out, quick, and then release for the turn.
Then we can show the footwork one solo?
Yes.
So that would be for the first one basic, sorry.
Slow, quick. Going in, quick, slow, quick.
Let's do it again.
Slow, quick. Going in. Quick, turn. Quick. I'm gonna show it for leaders, so you can watch me from the back. Then you can show it in the front.
Yeah, sure.
So, we're gonna start with the basic. Slow, quick. Going in. Quick, turn. Quick. How's everybody doing with that? Thanks, Sam. Give me a thumbs up if it's kind of clear. Do you have any questions for this one? Yeah, I see mixed feelings. Some thumbs up.
Yeah, I think for leading and following this, it's good to take some time to figure out how it feels. And maybe we play a song and we come back to it and then elaborate a little bit more on that feeling if needed. And for solo dances, I would like to give an extra challenge if you feel like challenging yourself, and that's to make that a double spin. Because in that redirect, you can create a lot of energy to spin twice.
Can you show how it looks like?
Oh wait, this side. I'll do it like this, then I have my focus.
Yeah. So if you say, okay, I'm a solo dancer, I have this nailed down, the first variation, just add a second turn after that,
so
during your quick.
You spin and I pivot on this foot and then I use the run.
Run for a second turn. Okay.
Let's play maybe the Lulu Swing song.
Yes, let's do that. Oh, actually I had it playing in the background. Thank you. How are you doing with this? Give me a thumbs up, middle, okay. Some mixed feelings, but mostly positive, I see. That's great. Are there any questions for this?
Yeah, for the double spin, I really try to focus on one spot. When I don't have to turn that far, it's not always necessary to spot, which means like staying focused at one spot while you turn. But when I do a double spin like that, I really choose a focus point, bring everything in, keep looking at that focus point while I spin. I hope that helps. And I bring everything, like I said, I bring this in, but I also bring my ribcage closer to my pelvis.
Okay, Lise, I see you have a question about the leading the
quick.
Do you mean the first or the second quick? So the one in the sugar push, okay.
Right?
So the difference between having a sugar push, regular one, in, out, slow, quick, and having the in, quick, slow, quick. Is that during the first slow in, or the end of the first slow in, here I really have quite a strong frame, and I give an impulse for the quick, and then release afterwards.
I feel very clear out and in.
Yeah. So after the first slow, I have this boink feeling, and then release.
And I say very clear, but it's subtle, right? It is a very small movement.
Yeah. So for the regular sugar push, it's kind of a steady movement out versus here, in, bzz, and then release.
The other one is more fluid, it goes more even.
Does this answer your question?
It is tricky though, it is a subtle difference, so it takes a bit of time to also get used to each other in this exercise. I would like to add one option for both solo dancers and also partners can also try this, and then play another song if that's good for you with skates.
Yes.
Yeah. So we've been working mostly on this half moon, but this half moon you can also replace by Superman, which would look like this.
So instead of going in, quick, slow, quick, you can replace the half moon and the second quick with a Superman. Going in, quick, Superman, break, and go into basic. Looks like this. Quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, Superman, and back into basic. So if you want, you can try it out, replace the second half moon with the quick, while we play another song for you. This one?
Yeah.
So this one starts really quick, but no worries, it's actually not that quick.
It's Chick-fil-A.
Thank you.
Cool.
I see Lise asking, it's like a push-off. It indeed is, yeah.
Which leg is it on for follows? Or follows or leads, Sam? Follows.
So I push off with my right, and then I Superman on my left, and I bring it back in the end.
Yeah. So it is the quick, and then the Superman.
So to show the whole thing, redirect.
Left, hold. And then you start with your basic again.
And then I start with the basic. Is clear?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly, Sam. The hitch is without switching the leg.
Yeah.
Cool.
Cool.
Good. Then we would like to move on to our next thing.
Something different.
Something completely different. So we still took inspiration from our first figure, which to remind you is this. Hey, boom. But in this case, we just took the idea of having solo jazz moves next to each other. And then Julia was kind of studying the camel walk at the time.
Studying the camel walk. I wrote a thesis on it. No, yes. I didn't.
So we wondered how we could implement our camel walk into Czech next to each other. So how's your camel walk knowledge? Yeah,
how
like?
Comfortable are you with your camel walk?
Are you good? Are you kind of okay with it? Have you never heard of the camel walk?
All comfortable people.
I see somebody logging off already. No. That's not a good sign.
I see that everyone is comfortable, that is comfortable enough to say so. If not, you can also drop it in the chat.
We can have maybe a small exercise for it, just to kind of
refresh it a little bit. Yeah.
And then we can move on to what we actually want to do afterwards.
This is my speed camel walk class.
Intensive 5-minute crash course on camel walks.
So okay. I like this idea of putting the weight on one leg and then dropping the other knee, popping it, right? It automatically goes.
Yeah. So you're gonna pop out your legs.
Pop.
Point. The other foot down to the floor. Boom. Boom. Right. Boom.
While doing this, we can travel.
You can walk forwards.
Or sideways. All right. We're gonna travel 3 steps right, 3 steps left. So we're gonna think right, left, right, left. And this is gonna be the same for leads and follows.
Yeah.
So it's gonna be...
Everybody starts with the right leg. So we're gonna start right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Maybe it's shoulder from the back as well.
Yeah.
5, 6, 7, and right, left, right, left, right, left. Right, left, right, left, right, left.
So we can engage our upper body a little bit and emphasize this movement with dropping the upper body in that diagonal and backwards.
Yes.
Like this. 5, 6, 7, 8. So that will help with leading it later. And then another thing that you can do to make it look prettier is to instead of stepping next to your foot, slide that foot past your foot. So it's gonna be So I want to do a quick exercise where we do a basic and then 2 basic camel walks. So that's gonna look like this. Slow, quick. Basic. Camel walk.
So we're gonna have 2 basics and then kind of 4 camel walks or 2, however you want to call kind of.
I do one basic. One basic.
One basic. Sorry.
And then
one basic and 2 camel walks. Let's try this out all together. 5, 6, basic. So I just noticed that for leads, it means you're gonna start on the other leg.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Because we do this together, right?
I know. I have a small trick to change my feet afterwards. So.
But which foot do you want them to practice it on now?
For now, let's just all start the basic on our right leg, because leaders, we also want to try it on the other side, our basics. It doesn't hurt. So let's all start the slow, quick on our right side.
Let's play with the swing once more, and we can do this to music for a little while before we move forward. Sorry, I think we have to take one step back. What are we doing?
Yeah, so
you had a different system, Chariot.
Yeah, so I have a blackout right now.
Okay, we're gonna do slow, quick, camel walk, double basic, camel walk, second, basic. I hope that clarifies it. Let me do it once more.
Is it clear for you what you have to do now? Give us a yes, not really.
You can also freestyle and do your own thing, of course. But this is what we're doing.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, exactly.
With all the others, I am looking back in time. But in your eyes, I melt away like ice cream on a summer day. Just one more thing, baby. My life wouldn't be worthwhile till down the middle aisle with the ice swing.
Perfect.
Cool.
And I see that Sam has already guessed our next step, or next step in the build up.
It's kind of a goofy feeling indeed, because you're bouncing throughout this whole thing, like keeping that shag ball, so it's a bit odd indeed.
Yeah.
So I saw some struggling a little bit with that transition. So you have to slow, quick, and then you bend your left. And you drop down on that right. Slow, quick, onto the right, onto the left.
Yeah. And to solve that issue for leaders to switch from our regular left-sided basic to the right side, we're gonna replace the quick just with a third slow or a double hop, whatever you wanna call it. So instead of going slow, quick, we're gonna go slow, so we can start on our right side. I'm gonna show it from the back as well. So instead of going slow, quick, we're gonna go slow, double hop. So we can start with our right, left, right.
Okay? I understand now.
So that was the issue that was kind of blocking my brain before.
I understand, yeah.
Let's just try it out, maybe partnered right away.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah. So to get into this, we found out the easy. First, we tried it side by side. From this one, coming from this one, we just tried this one.
But it felt a bit bumpy.
Exactly. It feels a bit awkward and cramped.
It's possible, but it doesn't really show those nice lines as much.
Exactly. So we decided to go in a different way, from a right to a right hand hold, just having a regular turn in. Boom. Okay, let's just try this out. If you're solo, rock your camel walks.
We'll show it once more for those who want to see it again, but feel free to try it already.
If you're partners and leaders, don't forget the three slows. Slow, 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 camel, walk, camel, walk, camel, walk, camel, walk.
Oh, I'm sorry, Sam.
Okay, we're going to give you a little bit of music to try this out. Up.
Oh, I'm fine.
How is everybody doing with this?
Yeah, no, that's a very valid question. I always like to first see how it feels if they do it naturally and then discuss it indeed.
Yes.
So we spoke about that body movement before to emphasize the move when you do it solo to make it look nicer, but it also works really well to lead it.
Yeah, so what I will do as a leader is I will really clearly have the direction straight over diagonal and kind of get my leg underneath here and do the same in the other direction as well.
So we will have a little bit of a forward backwards sensation,
yeah.
A subtle.
So it's very subtle, but I think I kind of try to flatten out my bounce a little bit. Boom, 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 boom.
And
have really this single time going on. Well, Martina and Simon, for us it works.
Yes, it helps that we have a shared ID, I guess. But you can try it someday again on the social floor and see what it does. But this backwards forwards, it is quite a traditional shape, so it might actually work.
Yeah, so it depends a little bit how well you know your partner. So in the start, it might indeed be a combo, and then leading it socially, maybe first to slower songs, and then later on build it up.
I have one other tip to make this work well, and it is to spin the follow a little bit faster. So that catches early, and then you have more time to prep, because otherwise it becomes rushy and it's unclear.
Yeah, to demonstrate that, if I turn my follow in very slow and kind of then start pushing her or him this direction, I will try to kind of get my follow to my side as quickly as possible. Slow, slow, slow. So that with the quick, he or she will already be on my side.
We're already fully connected.
And we can start this together. That helps a lot too.
Exactly. Yeah, then it would be quick. If you would follow it with normal steps, that would work too, but then I would be Walking.
Yeah, we would kind of just run next to each other.
Boom, boom, boom.
Yeah, we would kind of have this parade next to each other.
I might be a bit confused by what's going on, but it works rhythmically.
It sounds funny though, let's try that. Slow, 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 run, 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 run. Yeah, it kind of works. Kind of works. All right. Now you might ask yourself, how do we get out of this again? We're kind of next to each other.
Yeah.
So we're going to have actually our followers turn on the
last
camel hop, or replace the last camel walk with a turn. We're going to show you how this looks so you can kind of measure what it should look like. Quick, 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 double hop to get back into basics once more. Camel walks, camel, camel prep, turn, back into basic.
So solo, that would look like this.
Julia's gonna show it solo.
Hmm?
Julia's gonna show it solo. Double, yeah, exactly. So the last
run.
Yeah, in the second to last camel hop, you're gonna have a prep and then counter turn. Let's all do it solo.
Let's try it.
Let's all do it solo. 5, 6, 7, and camel. What?
It's one solo and then good.
Okay,
one basic. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Slow, slow, quick.
Camel walk, camel walk, camel prep.
Yeah.
Once more. 5, 6, 7, 8. Basic. Camel walk.
Camel walk. Camel walk. Camel prep.
Run, run, run. Solo dancers, just style out that Shorty George how you like it. camel walk.
Camel Shorty George.
Camel,
yes.
Shorty. Camel. Shorty camel.
Shorty camel.
If you go down.
Yeah. Okay. Also a cool idea. Leaders, you have to beware that you have to switch the other leg again. So for leaders, it will be 3 camel walks. Camel walk, camel walk, camel prep. So you need to prep your partner here. And then it's going to be a step, double hop. Catch your partner and go into basic. All right, we're gonna give you a song to try this out. If you're solo, rock your shorty shoulders during the camel walks, and let's all try this turn. All right.
Last 3 minutes.
Last 3 minutes. We're gonna use our last 3 minutes to show you one more thing where you can use the camel walk just in your social dancing, which is this one is a very good spot for it. If you're just going around in a circle, slow, slow, quick, quick, camel, camel, and slow, slow, quick, quick, camel, camel, slow, slow, quick, quick, camel.
And you can also do it by yourself.
Slow, slow, quick, quick. So this is an independent footwork variation that you can just sprinkle in if you feel like it.
Exactly.
Okay, with this, we would like to ask if there are any more questions. Do you need any more detail on anything? We have 2 minutes left.
If not, no. We are gonna use it to
give you some more music.
Give you some more music. But before we do that, thank you very much for joining us.
Yeah.
It was really fun to do this.
It was our first online class. We held out for an entire year, but then we heard Anna's and Egle's call to teach online. And yeah, here we are.
And I would like to point out, I think there's a lot of cool classes, of course, today. I think Gabi is going to do something with solo jazz material in Shag as well. So that might align nice with this material that we did. But there is a full schedule, of course.
Yeah.
And I hope to see you all next week at Swing Paradise.
I think she will also do some St. Louis Shag next week. Exactly.
We will be joining as students next week. I think maybe Eglo Arnos can share over the day a bit more about the teacher. So we're going to teach because I don't know the lineup by heart.
Yeah.
But we'll be there joining the classes.
Okay. Let's give you some more music and otherwise take a break and see you in the next class.
Maybe. Yeah, the other one is nice. Chick Web.
Enjoy the rest of your days. Bye-bye.